chairs is a 10-year-old fourth grader, Miss Nielsen's class. It's his favorite subject. His attendance spring garden since kindergarten. His best school memories are his friends and playing. Now, Christmas morning, Houston, his sister Amanda has 4 dogs, a bird, and 28 tropical fish. His dad is his hero. He enjoys karate, dance classes, and plays soccer. Harry Potter, the prisoner of Azkaban, by J.K. Rowling, is his favorite book by his favorite author. He was inspired to write this book because he likes to write. This has published other books from the Truly Classic Fellowship Company. Before I read this, and it's dedicated to his family, I was at one of our high schools today judging senior projects. And one of the ladies, one of the seniors that I judged, she too is a writer. And for her project, she wrote a novel. A 50,000-word novel. She hopes to have published. It's all about fairies and dragons and wizards and but she began to choose him at 8 years old at an elementary school here in this district and said, maybe I'll tell you sooner you'd be writing novels as well. Andrew Anaconda outsmarts Leo Leopard. I won't able to show you all the artwork. It's excellent. It's in detail that you can see what all the animals in the forest are saying. I'm sure Chris will show this to you when you can put it in a few moments. One hot day in the rainforest, Andrew Anaconda was slithering in the hot summer sun. He didn't know it, but Leo Leopard was watching from the bushes. Leo Leopard was hated by all snakes and almost everyone else in the rainforest because he ate their kind. Leo Leopard began stalking Andrew Anaconda. But as he was about to leave, he stepped on a branch, and Andrew Anaconda bolted for his hold. Leo Leopard walked away without his snake bit. Andrew Anaconda called a meeting of all the animals, and they all agreed something had to be done. They all shared their ideas, but they voted for Andrew Anaconda's idea of digging a pit. They decided to make the pit 20 feet deep, so Leo Leopard would not be able to jump out. The animals went to the location of the hole and began to dig deeper and deeper. Finally, after a day of digging, they were done and were ready for the covering. They gathered twigs and large leaves and began covering the pit. Then they cleared the bushes and waited for Leo Leopard. And after a while, Leo Leopard got the scent of the snake and began walking towards the pit. Well, he found the clearing, saw the animals, and then his view was lost as he tumbled down the bottom of the pit. Ah, let me out, he roared. Not until you find something else to eat besides us. Well, what else can I eat? You can eat grass. I hate grass. The more you eat it, the more you like it. I like spinach, right? Yeah, okay. Well, I'll try, said Leo Leopard. After a few bites, he realized the animals were right. It wasn't too bad after all. After that day, the animals never had to worry about being eaten because they were now friends. Luckily, after a while, Leo Leopard didn't feel like eating the animals anymore. Of all the lessons in here, there's quite a few. Maybe we can all learn that even those people, sometimes we feel like they were our enemies, under the right circumstances, maybe they even become our friends. Here's what I'd like to bring.